on today. I come be buddy today to bring another video. Not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Amen. And I like to ask that she empower my crystalline eye, heart, in throat shot, but all my shots. And I may speak not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Like to say, some of my beloved precepts, which is Psalms 51 and 11. And it goes a little bit like this. Cast me not away from thy presence. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me thy joy and thy salvation. And uphold me with all thy free spirit. Back in the glory. Only through the Shekinah that is from the Father shall we get overstanding. So, with that being said, we're going to say some of our ministries that we provide for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? So if you want to contact us, the best way is to go to Upper Eons on Facebook. Well, that ain't the best way. The best way is through our emails. You know what I'm saying? But you can contact us on Facebook, Upper Eons on Facebook, but the best way is the emails. The first one is dothemann@al.com. dothemann@al.com. And then you got my email. That's my big brother Rodolph's email, dothemann@al.com. And you got my email, dearbaysvr@gmail.com. We got a book buying ministry. You need a Nag Hammadi, contact us. The Nag Hammadi is in the Bible. It's Numbers 21:14. Those of y'all who are interested. We got a food ministry named after my big brother Rodolph, beloved mother, Chandra Johnson. You know what I'm saying? If you know any women or children that may need assistance, contact us. We'll see what we can do. We got a video ministry by my brother Benaya and my brother Chase. You know what I'm saying? All the information is in the description box at the bottom of the video. And then we got a blog talk at Lord's Will every Sunday at 11 a.m. And then we got a pal talk every Sunday at 12 p.m. You know what I'm saying? The pal talk is called the Sons of the L. Number two, Sons of the L, number two, all capital letters. You know what I'm saying? Sons of the L, number two, all capital letters. You know what I'm saying? So, those are the ministries that we provide for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? So, if you're interested, that is the information. Now, what we're going to talk about today is baptism. You know what I'm saying? And not in the sense of your traditional overstanding of baptism. You know what I'm saying? So, and this is only one small aspect of baptism. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, let's move to the video that we may get overstanding truly of what this stuff is saying. Now, what we're going to do today is, you know what I'm saying? We're going to, like I said, we're going to talk about baptism, an aspect of it. Baptism is, baptism, to keep it real, baptism is an alchemical process. You know when Thoth always talk about alchemy? And say Thoth was the master alchemist. You know what I'm saying? That's metaphysical overstanding. You know what I'm saying? So, baptism is a part of an alchemical process. You know what I'm saying? Of the green light. You know what I'm saying? The green light is yellow and blue. You know what I'm saying? Green light is not visible by the naked eye. You know what I'm saying? It's an alchemical process. In baptism, is a vibration. You know what I'm saying? A frequency. Electromagnetic energy, which is a frequency. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I said this is only a small aspect of what baptism really is. You know what I'm saying? And it goes back to our process of coming down into this realm and being raised back up. You know what I'm saying? I thank the great mother for giving me understanding to do these things, because she is the one who guides me to do her great work. You know what I'm saying? The great work has many aspects, and it consists of many individuals. Just don't one person have this aspect. Or can do all these aspects. It, like I said, take a village to raise a family. You know what I'm saying? It take a village or a whole body. You know what I'm saying? To do this work and this will of the great mother. You know what I'm saying? Play your part. You know what I'm saying? But what we're going to do right now is, we're going to pause for a minute to give thanks to the great divine Metanetta, great mother herself. You know what I'm saying? That we may have understanding truly of what she is saying. You know what I'm saying? So bear with me for a minute. You know what I'm saying? Bear with me for a minute. We're going to give thanks to the great mother to truly have understanding truly of what she is saying about great things of old. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we're going to do right now. So we're going to pause for a minute to give thanks to the great divine Metanetta. You know what I'm saying? Because she is truly worthy. She give me understanding of great things of old. You know what I'm saying? And not just me. You know what I'm saying? There's plenty of people out here thanking the great divine mother. You know what I'm saying? Now, I will say this. You know, the way the great mother speaks through me is unique. You know what I'm saying? I haven't seen many brothers out there speaking the way I do. But that is the gift she gave me. You know what I'm saying? But there's plenty of brothers out there. And I'm saying brothers because, bear with me. I'm saying brothers because, you know, women, man, they'll holler at the great mother quick. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of men, you know, they don't like to acknowledge the great mother. And whatever reason it may be for them, ego, or they don't want to lose power, control, whatever their reason may be. But to keep it real, the great mother herself is the one who give you the power. You know what I'm saying? Like Messiah said, if you are too ashamed to acknowledge me, I'm going to be too ashamed to acknowledge you before the great mother herself. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's brothers out there acknowledging the great mother. And some of us say it in esoteric ways. You have to know what they're saying to understand what they are saying. But I'm just flat out saying the great divine Metanetta, you know what I'm saying? I ain't cutting no cards, because she don't want me to cut no cards. You know what I'm saying? The great divine mother, Oshun, you know what I'm saying? And her partner, Yamayam, you know what I'm saying? Ayana, Hathor, Ishtar, Isis, You're saying Mary and Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Kali. You know what I'm saying? Seshet. Shakti. You know what I'm saying? It's many names of the great mother. You know what I'm saying? Man, I'm telling you. The great mother got me working on another aspect of her glory. It's no mistake. You can't get around this stuff. When the great mother give you the divine glasses to see her, when the great mother give you the divine glass to see her, I mean, she is everywhere. It's no denying it. Once she give you those great divine glasses, you see her everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Oh, man, even in the nuclear acid in your body. You know what I'm saying? Nuclear acid is basically your DNA. You know what I'm saying? She is everywhere. She is everywhere. Everywhere you look, she is there. That's why I said if you want to see God, just look around. It's the great mother herself. You know what I'm saying? Oh man, when you look around and she give them glasses, you can see her everywhere. You know what I'm saying? You know the old saying, as above, so below. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, this is an absolute truth, what I'm about to say right here. This is an absolute truth that cannot be denied. You know what I'm saying? You better hear what I'm saying. Let me give you absolute truth, another one. There's many of them, but I'm just saying this one. You know the old saying in the Bible when it say, when you say your prayer, when Messiah said, this is how you pray, and you say, on earth as it is in heaven, or as it is in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven, or like Thoth in the ancient text say, as above, so below, as below, so above. Look at this right here. You know how, okay, I don't want to bring this up, but I'm going to say it for teaching and learning purposes. Only teaching and learning purposes only. Yeah, you know, since I've been talking about the great divine mother, you know what I'm saying, YouTube jump on my back, you know what I'm saying, they get a brother warning, you know what I'm saying. you get talking about information they don't want you to talk about. Oh, they're gonna come after you, you know what I'm saying. I got to talk about this green light and stuff like that. What? Oh, man, they came after me. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, like I said, you look at my channel, the views done went down, but the messages and the likes done went up. So how can your messages and likes go up, but the views go down? That don't even make no damn sense. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Hey, long as I keep continue to do the work, long as the great mother continue to allow me to do her great work, it's going to be done regardless of what the Gentiles do. You know what I'm saying? Well, let me get to the point I was saying, this absolute truth. Remember George Floyd, when they had the knee on his neck, and they say his last words was, "Mama, I want my mother." You know, a lot of men die, you know what I'm saying, at the hands of the law. I'm going to say it like that. By the hands of the law. And you hear a lot of men crying for their mother, their last words. You know what I'm saying? They say their mother, they say, "Mama, I want my mama," or "Mama, I see mama." You know what I'm saying? Or when you take your, like I said, you take your last breath, breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. You know what I'm saying? You said breathe in one more time. Breathe in, breathe out. You saying Yahweh, the great mother. You know what I'm saying? But these brothers be saying mother, that be their last word. Why they don't never say Jesus? You know what I'm saying? When on their last breath, Why they don't say that? Or why they don't say, Father, Most High? Why they don't say that? Huh? Why they don't say, Most High, I'm coming to your arms. Or Jesus, I'm on my way. You know what I'm saying? What they say? They say, Mama, I see you. Or Mother. They always call her their mother. When a man get in trouble, he trying to get home. He trying to get home to his mother, or he trying to get home to his girlfriend or his wife. You know what I'm saying? As below, so above. When the baby come out the mother's womb, who is that baby's God? When the baby come out the mother's womb, whether it's male or female, who is that baby's God? As below, so above. As above, so below. That baby, whether it's male or female, that mother is its God. Because she nourish him with the breast. She nourish him when he crying and when he hungry. She comforts him. Look at the comfort. She comforts him. Look at the comforter. She comforts him. Look at the comforter. She do all it needs to make sure it survives in this world. And if you mess with a baby's mother, she'll knock your block off. And you know what I'm saying. You don't mess with a, especially a so-called black woman's baby. You know what I'm saying? But you don't mess with a woman's baby. Either animal kingdom or the human kingdom. You don't mess with a woman's baby. She'll lose her cool and tear you up. You know what I'm saying? So my point is this. Why everybody called on the mother or want the mother when something go down? But it's because the dog, who he want? He want his mama or he want his wife or his girlfriend. And he like a little dang baby crying on her. Baby, baby. You know what I'm saying? As above, so below. As below, so above. The great mother is giving you many examples that she is God. You know what I'm saying? That's another example. That's an absolute truth. Men, when they about to die, they call on their mother. When a baby, male or female, come out the womb, they dependent on their mother. That's their God. And that's why I said, as below, so above. As above, so below. The great mother show herself in many different ways that she is the true God of all things. And that is one little teeny weeny example of what I'm saying. Because she even show herself even in science. What they call today science. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, that's just another example I wanted to show you. Another absolute. You know what I'm saying? And you got to question yourself. Why they keep telling you that everything is a man? And the mother is the key to all things. You know what I'm saying? So let's move into the video that we may understand truly what these things are saying. You know what I'm saying? So on the screen, I got the green light. And you see the green light coming from the heavens, going into him. That's the green light you can't see. You know what I'm saying? Because he in the spiritual realm where you can see the green light. But in the physical aspect, you can't see the green light. You know what I'm saying? Because it's invisible. You know what I'm saying? It only manifests in the trees, in the grass, you know what I'm saying? In the vines, you know, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? But you can't see it in the physical realm. You know what I'm saying? So let's move on and get understanding what this alchemical process of baptism really is. Let's move on. All right, all right. Look at that. What is that? You know what I'm saying? That is the calendar of Dundar in Egypt. That's in the pyramid of the temple of Dundar. You know what I'm saying? If I said the name right. That's in the ceiling. Now let me say this. See, a lot of people think that Egypt was the place that Thoth went to when he left Atlantis. That's not true. Let me say that again. A lot of people think that Thoth went to Egypt. Well, he did go to Egypt, but a lot of people think he went over there in the Middle East and Africa when he left Atlantis. A lot of people think that. I'm going to show you that that's not true. You know what I'm saying? Check this out. The Americas is part of Atlantis. Atlanta is the capital of Atlantis. Atlanta, Georgia is the capital of Atlanta. Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? If you go to Georgia, look on top of all the buildings, they got all them pyramids all over the place. Got pyramids everywhere. in Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? That's why in Atlanta they push that agenda with mail, because they the Edomites know that's the capital. You know what I'm saying? Atlantis was in the Americas. I mean, but that's the capital aspect of it. You know what I'm saying? He left the ancients, they left Americas. Remember in the Keys of Enoch when I showed y'all that the first experiment was in the Americas, the Olmec experiment? So they left here and then they went over to Africa and set up the mystery schools over there. But they was over here in America first. That's why I told you the Grand Canyon was the place where the Sphinx and the Great Pyramid of the Great Pyramid of Gaza and all the other pyramids was in the in the Grand Canyon. That was all over there first. You know what I'm saying? And that's why they destroyed that damn I forgot the name of the park. They destroyed where the Sphinx was at. They destroyed that park. You couldn't come in there first till they got done tearing everything up, and then they let you come in there. You know what I'm saying? They had to hide that this was the first place where Thoth was at when Egypt fell, the Americas. You know what I'm saying? So let's get to this calendar. You see that calendar? See that calendar? That's the calendar of Dundar. That was created second. The Mayan calendar was created first. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't called the Mayan calendar first. You know what I'm saying? The Olmec calendar. You know what I'm saying? Or the Anunnaki or the Sumerian or whatever you want to go with it. That's what the name of that was first. That calendar in South America, the one that said that the end of the world was going to come in 2012, Inki did that. You know what I'm saying? They was in Americas first, and then they went up to Egypt and created the mystics over there. Then the calendar of Dundar was created. You know what I'm saying? So the Mayan calendar was created first. You know what I'm saying? But let's get to this calendar right here. Now that's the calendar in Dundar over there in Egypt. Look at that calendar. What y'all see on that calendar? What you see? You know what I'm saying? This is another example of all the gods at first, because this calendar is from Atlantis. That's the image from Atlantis. If you look at this, if you look at the calendar, you can see the three rings of Atlantis. You know what I'm saying? It's also a circle, which means the Great Mother. You know what I'm saying? And you see the green on the outside, the Great Mother herself. Look in the middle. You see the middle? See the hippo? The hippo represented the Great Mother herself. But we ain't gonna get in that aspect of the calendar, because that calendar, it got so much overstanding in it. But this video ain't about that, the hippo and all that right there. The hippo represented the Great Mother with the alligator on the back, but I ain't gonna get into all that. We just talking about the circle, which the circle is the Great Mother. Circles is feminine, you know what I'm saying? But look at the outside of the blue circle. See all them women around the circle? Every last one of them is a woman. Every last one of them is a woman. You know what I'm saying? They all around the circle. You know what I'm saying? And then you got the one, the men there that got the Ibis head on. You know what I'm saying? But all 12 of those things represents, you know, they made it look like that, but they all women. You know what? You know why I say they all women? Because you know what they represents? Those are the 12 sisters of Isis. I mean, the 12 daughters of Isis, or Iana, or Hathor, or Oshun. You know what I'm saying? Because you know they changed the African gods' name to the Greek gods. You know what I'm saying? But those are the 12 daughters of Isis. Those are the 12 daughters of Isis in the celestial realm. You see the four pillars, the big ones, the four big ones. They represent the four elements. You know, we can go all over with that. The four elements, all that stuff right there. You know what I'm saying? But they are the four pillars of creation. They are also the four stars. You know, you got the three stars of Orion's belt. And I keep telling y'all there's four stars to the Orion's belt. Those four main pillars, the four great sisters, are the four stars. But I ain't gonna get into that neither. You know what I'm saying? And then you got, if you count all the 12 sisters, you count all 12 of them. I mean, you count all the sisters, it's 12 of them. You know what I'm saying? You got two that's together. You got 2, 4, 6, 8. Then you got the other four. which is 12. You know what I'm saying? Those are the 12 daughters of Isis. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you get the 12 zodiacs and so forth, so forth, so forth, so forth. You know what I'm saying? And the great hippo in the middle was the 13th one. You know what I'm saying? But the 13th is not what I'm talking about right now. I'm just talking about the 12. Those are the 12 daughters of Isis. You know what I'm saying? And see how fast the time go? I done spent that little time, 30 minutes, that quick. You know what I'm saying? The time speed up when you talk about the great mother. Because the wicked ones, they hate with a passion, hate that we talk about this truth. So they'll speed the time up. But when you out here, you want to, something you don't want to do, that time be slower than the mud. Because you don't want to do it. You know what I'm saying? But let's move on to get overstanding. All right, look at that. Remember in Israel, that's why I said the 12 daughters of Isis is an alchemical process from the spiritual realm. And then you come down to the physical realm. Why did Israel have the same thing? Look at that. They got the circle, which represents, on the first picture, the Candle of Dundar, the blue stuff represents the waters. That's why it was blue. It represents the celestial waters. You know what I'm saying? Now look at Israel at the temple. You know, in the wilderness, when Moses made the temple, the tabernacle, and he had the 12 bulls or the 12 oxes with the big container on his back that was full of water, and they said it was for the baptism of the nations. You know what I'm saying? It was talking about the celestial realm. We're talking about the chemical process. That this message right here is for the disciples, or like people like Aaron that knew the mysteries, or the Essenes, the people that knew the mysteries. This is a mystery of the alchemical process. You know what I'm saying? See the three cows? You got three on the right, three on the left, or three on the north, three on the south, three on the east, three on the west. The same thing with the tribes. We had three tribes on the north, three tribes on the south, three tribes on the east, and three tribes on the west. You know what I'm saying? Symbolizing the zodiac. You know what I'm saying? And you know how they teach you not to even worry about the zodiac. But it's all in the design of the children of Israel. You know what I'm saying? In the whole dynamic of that nation. It all represents the 12 zodiacs, or the 12 sisters of Isis. I mean, the 12 daughters of Isis. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. See the circle in the middle full of water? It's the celestial waters. It's a process you must go through to get back to the celestial realm. You know what I'm saying? So I wanted to show you that picture. 12 sisters, and you got 12 oxes. And what do the oxes represent? Remember my last video? I told you about the white buffalo, and it said that Isis is the bull of heaven. You see the bull horns represents the crescent moon. And all Israel holidays fall on a full or a new moon. You know what I'm saying? So the horns represents the 12 sisters, which is the 12 crescent moons. I mean, the 12 daughters of Isis, which represents the 12 crescent moons. That's why they all got horns. You don't see no cows there. You see bulls. You know what I'm saying? Or they say oxes. But they all got horns, which represents the 12 daughters of Isis, the 12 crescent moons. That's why they call Isis the bull of heaven, or the white buffalo, the bull of heaven. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to move on through this. I'm just trying to break this down to y'all to give you understanding what is going on. Baptism is an alchemical process. It's an alchemical process how you fail, and it's an alchemical process how you must go back up. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say you got to raise your vibration. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on. All right. Let's read this. This out of the book of Enoch. You know what I'm saying? The great mother gave me this. Because I didn't know this breakdown my dang self. This the great mother gave me this. You know what I'm saying? Let's get this. All right. Now, this out of the book of Enoch, but I got it off on the internet because I wanted to put it on the screen like this. The book of Enoch, I ain't feel like go digging that joke out. You know what I'm saying? It say, why is the cow or the bull, all the great mothers are represented as the bull of heaven because of their horns, which is the crescent moon or the new moon. You know what I'm saying? And some people say the moon is bad. Some say it's good. In this realm, it's still the feminine aspect. and sometimes they make it masculine. But that's, when you go to the celestial realm, it's good. But when you come to the physical realm, they use it as bad. But that's neither here nor there. Let's break this down. It says, why is the bulls depicted in the temple arrangement of Israel? See that? But I just showed you that's in Egypt. You know what I'm saying? But I told you the name of Israel is Egypt. Isis, Ra, and El. El is the child. So you got Egypt right in the name of Israel. Isis, Ra, you know what I'm saying? Amen or Amun is Isis. Ra is the father. Isis is Amun. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to show you Amun in this video. You know what I'm saying? The great mother herself, or aspect of her. You know what I'm saying? It say, why is the cows or the bulls depicted in the temple arrangement of Israel? Let's skip with that. Let's skip with that. Okay, bear with me. Okay, let's read that. It say, has anyone ever read the cow prophecy of Enoch? Okay, and you know if Enoch did it, you know, because Enoch is Thoth. You know it's an alchemical process, because Thoth he was the wisest in magic or alchemy. So let you know it's an alchemical process. It say, then the white cow, this is Enoch chapter 88 verse 12 through 17, if you want to read it in the book of Enoch. It say, then the white cow, see that white cow or white buffalo, which is Isis or Anna, you know what I'm saying, the queen or bull of heaven, you know what I'm saying, then the white cow, which became a man, see that, went out of the ship, and the three cows with him, see that, it go through the lineup of the three cows, three north, three west, you know what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying. And when they say the white cow, it's talking about the white cow is Iana, the great mother. She went out and three followed her. It said three cows went with him or her. You know what I'm saying? Because the cow represents the great mother. But they're going to use all masculine aspects. So just know that it's talking about feminine. It said the white cow, which is the white buffalo, which is the great mother, or the hippo in the middle of the zodiac, which became a man. See that? The great mother Christ, who came down in Jesus. Or Messiah, the great, I'm going to say that again, the white cow, which is Christ, which came down in the physical aspect of a man who was Jesus or Messiah, the white cow, which became a man, went out of the ship, and the three cows with him, you know what I'm saying, those are three tribes, one of the three cows was white, resembling that cow, which was resembling the great mother. One of them was red as blood, and one of them was black. You know what I'm saying? Those are the four colors. Because remember, it's the white, the black, and the red. Those are the four primary colors of this third dimension. And I'm going to show you that later on. It says, resembles that cow. One of them was red, one of them was black, and the white cow left them. Right, you know what I'm saying? Then began wild beasts and birds to bring forth of all these the different kinds assembled together. Lions, tigers, wolves, dogs, and boars, foxes, rabbits, and hens are, you say the cits, the kits, and the funkies, how do you say that, and the ravens. Then the white cow was born in the midst of this. See, you're talking about the great mother in the physical world. See, what that was an alchemical process. See, they came from the celestial realm, like the first Dundar, the calendar of Dundar I showed you that was in the celestial realm. Then they came down to the physical world. That's what I just told you. It said they began, see, they came out of the ship, the celestial ship. You know what I'm saying? And they came down to the physical world. It said then began wild beasts and birds and bring forth me being born. Of all these, the different kinds assembled together. Lions, tigers, wolves, dogs, bears. See, that's talking about an alchemical process coming down into the physical world. It say, then the white cow was born in the midst of them. See that? The white cow born again. You know what I'm saying? In the midst of them. That's the great mother, or Isis, and her 12 daughters. You know what I'm saying? And that's why the zodiac is symbolizing all animals. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep reading. go to the next one on the right hand side. It say the story continues to allude to the creation of the nations of Israel. See that? Israel is the zodiac up in the sky. First we were celestial, then we came down in the physical. It's an alchemical process. That's what baptism is talking about. And Christ showed you that in the crucifixion. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. The story continues to allude to the creation of the nations of Israel through animal symbolism. Yup, the zodiac. Animal symbolism through the zodiac. You know what I'm saying? It says the cow represents leaders and the sheep represents those who followed them. See that? Animals. The Egyptians were depicted as wolves. I always thought it was a strange that the Israelites would be sometimes reverted back to cow worship. They weren't worshiping no cow. They was thanking the great mother. She is the great bull of heaven. Now see, they took the word cow. They took away bull because they know bull go back to Egypt. They don't want you to link that together because cows ain't got no damn horns. You know what I'm saying? So that's why they said cow instead of bulls. You know what I'm saying? But the bulls go back to Egypt. The horns is the crescent moon. That's why all the Israel holidays are on the new moon, the crescent moon. You know what I'm saying? So, oh man, I forgot something, but it's too late now. Okay, it say, the Egyptians were depicted as the wolves. I always thought it was strange that the Israelites would be sometimes reverted back to the cow worship, which is Isis, the great mother. And wasn't no worship, it was thanks. There is the case of building a golden calf at Mount Sinai. See that? That's right. Because they were still trying to live in that age where they was moving down in vibration. You know what I'm saying? Another alchemical process. You know what I'm saying? They were still trying to think the mother on a higher level, the golden age of Sophia. And that wouldn't end no more. So they couldn't do it on that level no more. You know what I'm saying? It said the golden calf of Mount Sinai. It said, second case is when the northern 10 tribe kingdoms of Israel set up two golden calves after they apostatized from Jerusalem. And that's what they did. They were thanking the great mother. You know what I'm saying? That's what they was doing. Thanking the great mother. See, they all, the symbolism, when you understand the symbolism, you know what's going on. You know what I'm saying? They say, another strange thing to note is the molten sea basin. That's the basin. See that horn? I mean the horn. See the big basin that the water is inside of? That water in there represents the celestial realms. It represents the golden age. That's why it was golden. It represents Sophia's world. Sophia is Isis or Ishtar or Iana. It's all the same stuff. It's just different energy. The same energy coming in different avatars. You know what I'm saying? That's all it is. The same energy coming in different avatars. That's all it is. Reincarnation, if you want to use that word too. Another strange thing to note is that the molten sea basin of the tabernacle temple was held up by 12 bulls. They say cows, but it's bulls. The 12 daughters of Isis. You know what I'm saying? Or the 12 tribes of Israel. The great mother, she sustains creation, period. The great mother sustains creation, period. You know what I'm saying? No ifs, ands, buts about it. And that's the symbolism of all this. The gold calves represents Sophia, the golden age. It's an alchemical process of gold being transferred in different types of metal. You know what I'm saying? It say the 12 bulls or oxes, no other animal is depicted in the temple arrangement. Why is the cows given special treatment with the temple? Because it's talking about the 12 sisters. I mean, the 12 daughters of Isis. That's what they're talking about. The 12 great mothers. And if you look at the earth is divided into 12 sections. I said that before in one of my older videos about the 12 sections, how the earth was divided into 12 sections. They say four. Yeah, it is four, but it is 12 as well. They say the celestial realm was divided into 12 sections as well as the earth. In one of my other videos, I said that. You know what I'm saying? And it's true because it's talking about the 12 daughters of Isis. On the counter of Dundon. You know what I'm saying? So that's why you got the 12 bulls, three on each side. That's why the tents were set up like that. They're talking about the 12 daughters of Isis. Look that up on the internet. If you want, You don't have to take my word. Look up on the internet about the 12 daughters of Isis. You know what I'm saying? I was going to do that, but it would have took up the video talking about them and not getting the point across what the great mother told me to get across. So let's move on. Okay. Now let's go into the Quran. That's why I keep telling y'all the Quran, or explaining to y'all the Quran and the Bible are the same damn book. How the hell is the Quran different when it got all the damn same patriarchs? Most of the Quran talk about Moses, Abraham, Mary, Messiah. They don't call Messiah the prophet, but they say Messiah or Muhammad. You know what I'm saying? They talk about Aaron, Joseph, Joshua, Ishmael, Isaac, Isaiah, Jeremiah. How is all of them in the damn Quran? It's just like the Bible, and they different. It's the same stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's created division in us. And we fall for it all the time. I ain't gonna say all of us, a lot of us fall for it. You know what I'm saying? We Muslims, we different from y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all Israelites. You know what I'm saying? Read the book and talk about the same damn stuff. Moses on the Mount Sinai in the Quran. You know what I'm saying? How the hell is that different from the Bible? Same stuff. Like I said, they took over the Bible first, and he had to bring out the Quran to bring the children back to the green light. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't done with the green light neither. I got a video we working on that one too. Let me get what's on the screen with the Quran. All right, this is in the Quran. I got off the internet because I ain't want to. I got the Quran. I got to dig that out too. I wasn't gonna dig that out. Okay, it say on the left hand side, it say one of the 99 names of Allah. Get it? The 99 names of Allah. And we know Allah is the great mother. The God is La. A-L is God. La is goddess. You know what I'm saying? Is Nar, meaning light. And it means the green light. You know what I'm saying? It don't mean white light. It means green light. It says the absolute or pure light, which is Allah, which is the green light, cannot be perceived directly by created beings. See? You can't see the green light, just like I said at the beginning of the video. Green light you can't see in the physical spectrum. Green light you cannot see in the physical spectrum. I'm gonna say that one more time. You cannot see green light in the physical spectrum in the sense of all the light you see right now is white light or amber light or clear light or moonlight type light. You know what I'm saying? The green light, you can't see it in the physical body. Only through the auroras. That's coming from the celestial realms. That's why you can see that light. That's why the earth is more green light coming on the earth. That green light is powerful too. That green light is an angel. It's a messenger. But I ain't going to get into that right now. Let's keep reading. It say, one of the 99 names of Allah is Nur, meaning light. It means green light. The absolute or pure light, which is Allah, which is the green light, cannot be perceived directly by a created being. See that? You can't see it in the physical realm. Moses asked if he could see Allah. See that? Moses asked, could he see Allah? How the hell is the Quran and the Bible different? Y'all Muslims and Israelites, y'all just beating each other up for nothing. You know what I'm saying? Allah, Moses went and saw Allah, the great mother. You know what I'm saying? And y'all beating each other up for nothing. Y'all brothers and sisters. You know what I'm saying? That's another video. It say, Moses asked if he could see Allah, but Allah did not show, it say, himself. See, they all make everything masculine. Herself directly to Moses. Instead, she appeared to him via the burning bush. Exactly. The flames of the burning bush were yellow, which is the first color in which light appears in created beings. Right, yellow and blue. Those are the first ones you can see. Like the rays of the sun. Exactly. In order to be perceived, Allah created the universe. Exactly. Where light can appear against the darkness. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? And I can go to a lot about that, but we ain't going to do that. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the last paragraph on the left-hand side. It say, the three fundamental colors are red, black, and white. Remember the cows? Was it the cows? Was it the cows? Yeah, okay. Yeah, it was a red cow. Let me make sure. Hold up for a second. He said, bear me for a second. Yes, yes. When you remember the cows, it said a white cow, a red cow, and a black cow. Remember that when Enoch, when they came out of the celestial realm, it was the red cow, the black cow, and the white cow. See, they talk about an alchemical process. They're talking about light. You know what I'm saying? That's what they're talking about. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people don't know this. That's an alchemical process they're talking about. Now the Quran got the same thing. It said that the three fundamental colors are red, black, and white in the Quran. It says Surah 4, verse 27. Allah, the most glorious one, or the most high. See, it's the same stuff. Allah, the most high, or the most glorious one. Allah and the most high is the same damn thing in the Bible or the Quran. It's the great mother. You know what I'm saying? She is the most high. You know what I'm saying? But she come down in a new, in a masculine aspect, just like she did Jesus. I did the video about the third testament when it say Christ, the feminine aspect, came down in a masculine body. You know what I'm saying? It's her running the show, but she used whatever avatar she need. Jesus told you that when he said, I come back as a man, as a woman, as an old man, or an old woman, or a little boy, or a little girl. The great mother can use any avatar she want. You know what I'm saying? But I told you your soul is feminine. I showed you that out of the damn, the Nag Hammadi. Your soul is feminine. It can use any avatar it want. It is required, like I did in one of my other videos, for you to come down as a man and a woman. You know what I'm saying? So I let you know Jesus was Christ is feminine. But Messiah or Jesus is masculine. You know what I'm saying? Many times. With a great mother, she got through me many times and other people too. You know what I'm saying? It said the three fundamental colors are red, black, and white in the Quran, Surah Fatar, verse 27. Allah, the most glorious one, says, among the mountains are streaks, white and red, and varying colors, and others very black. See that? That's why I got those two pictures there. It's talking about, I ain't gonna get into that, but that's also talking about the trees, the giant trees that was on the earth that reach up to the firmament. That's part of that process too. You know what I'm saying? But they call them mountains today. You know what I'm saying? You know, Devil's Mountain or Devil's Peak. That's one of the giant trees that went all the way up to the firmament. That's one of them giant trees. It's also in the Bible when they talk about Nebuchadnezzar was a tree that reached up to heaven. They talk about one of the giant trees that was on the earth before the flood. You know what I'm saying? But they call them mountains today. It's talking about the divine tree. You know what I'm saying? And that has multiple overstanding too. But this video ain't about that. Let's move on. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the bottom half of the right hand side. It say, the colorful mountains. It say, a meteorite goes through three stages. See that? Now we talk about the alchemical process. And I'm going to show you that it's an alchemical process of baptism. Baptism is an alchemical process. When you say crucifixion, crucifixion talk about resurrection. When you get crucified, it's talking about resurrection. Resurrection, that means you up in the celestial realm. Crucifixion means a higher vibration. People think crucifixion is terrible. Ah! The way the Edomites presented it, it is terrible. But you must crucify the body. Meaning you must raise it up, kill the flesh, and go to a higher vibration. That's what crucifixion means, a higher vibration, a higher frequency. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. It say, on the right-hand side of the bottom, it say, a meteorite goes through three stages. You know how the fallen angels come down into the physical body? That's what it's talking about. It is bright white in space. See, you're a celestial being. An alchemical process. When you came down here, it's an alchemical process when you go back up. That's why Christ said you must be born again. You must be baptized and born again. You must go through that alchemical process again to go back up there. It is bright white in space. See that? A divine being, a celestial being. You know what I'm saying? Burning red as it enters the atmosphere. See that? Transformation. Transformation. know what I'm saying? From celestial to physical. Transformation. From celestial to spirit. I mean, from celestial to physical. Burning red as it enters the atmosphere. See that? That was those red cows, the black cows, and the white cows was talking about. And the white cow that was in the middle. It's about the great mother and them coming down to the physical realm. It's talking about Genesis, the two creation stories in the book of Genesis. You know what I'm saying? It say, burning red as it enters the atmosphere and charred black when it comes to the earth. See, the black man. That just showed you too that the true people of God are so-called black people, because to talk about the melanin or the carbon that you are in now. The Nag Hammadi tell you that it made physical bodies for the divine children of Sophia to be trapped in the temple of God, the physical body. You know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? See, the great mother give you understanding to see these great things. You know what I'm saying? It's saying charred black when it comes to the earth. Black, white, and red also marks the three alchemical stages. See that? The three alchemical stages. See, it's an alchemical process. That's what those 12 bulls is all about, with the divine water in the bucket. I mean, you must get baptized to go through the alchemical process to go back, or crucify the flesh to go back up to the celestial realms. You know what I'm saying? That's what that was all about. You know what I'm saying? It's saying black, white, and red also marks the three alchemical stages of Niger Dew. Niger Dew. Bear with me for a second. Okay. These are the three. Now look on the right hand side of the bottom. It say black, white, and red also marks the three alchemical stages of Niger Dew. Niger Dew is black. Because see, Niger, remember when the beans are the Goya beans, the black Goya beans? Black. Niger is black. Niger Dew is black. Albedew is white. Al, God. Remember I say Al, Allah, A-L? That's God. That's white. You know what I'm saying? The moon. Allah. Albedew is white. In Rubedew is red. Ruby, red ruby. You know what I'm saying? Red contains all the other colors in potential form. One of the Spanish words for red is Colorado. That's why Colorado is all red. It's talking about Colorado mean red in Spanish. The Red Mountains. That's why the Indians was called the Red Man. I mean, the Red Indian. You know what I'm saying? And Colorado is where the Grand Canyon is at. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? That's why I say man was made from the red. You ever heard man was made from the red clay of the earth? That's talking about the black man too. You know what I'm saying? So-called black man. Which just means colored red. You know what I'm saying? So that's all of that. But I just want to show you that that's an alchemical process that we went through. We fell through an alchemical process. And when you get baptized through fire. You get baptized through water, physical water and celestial water. You know what I'm saying? You get baptized through divine oil. That's what the oil was about in Egypt, about the alligator oil and the hippo oil. You got to get baptized through oil. That's the oil in your pineal, your pineal gland or your spinal cord. It's talking about that type of oil. It's talking about the fire at the base of your spine. It's talking about the waters of the body. When you come into this world, you come through water, don't you? That's the first baptism right there. The first baptism when you come in from the celestial realm into your mother's womb. That's the first baptism right there. That's celestial coming out to the physical water, to the celestial waters. You know what I'm saying? Your mother's womb. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on. Get over standing. Okay. Now, let's read this right here on the screen. Bear with me. Let's read this on the screen. Bear with me. Okay. See, I got... See the colors? It got red, white, and black. know what I'm saying? Red, white, and black. But you got that color in the middle, which is between black and white and whatever. You know what I'm saying? But it's four stages of these colors. You got red, black, and white. You know what I'm saying? But it's four, the ether color. You know what I'm saying? That's in there too. It say the four stages of alchemy. And that's what happened to you when you came down to the physical world. The alchemy, it was the baptism process of alchemy. They just say baptism, but baptism is an alchemical process. You know what I'm saying? It say the four stages of alchemy. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I got a picture of those four circles. You know what I'm saying? Your soul is a circle. But see how they intertwine each other? They overloop, which is the vesica Pisces. You know what I'm saying? Or the universal womb. You know what I'm saying? So out of all four circles, get a loop on the left-hand side. Let's go to the right-hand side. Let's read that right there. It say, in Solomon's temple, a large molten sea of brass was placed on the backs of the 12 bronze oxes. Bronze is another color for black as well. You know what I'm saying? It's put in the furnace. You know what I'm saying? It's talking about the 12 daughters of Isis in the celestial waters who fell in the alchemical process down into the carbon of the earth. That's what it's talking about. You know what I'm saying? You need to understand that you are a celestial being. Sophia in the Great Mother has always been there. And they're going to always be there. The 12 cows or bulls represents the 12 daughters of Isis. Google that. The 12 daughters of Isis. Women. And they are the ones who hold the world up. They are the foundation of the earth in the celestial realm and in the physical realm. A woman, not no man. You know what I'm saying? A woman, not no man. It's a woman, not no man, that holds this earth up. They made it to Atlas holding up the earth. You know what I'm saying? But that's not true. It's women that do all this. The council, man, I could get in so much with this, but I ain't gonna get into it. You know what I'm saying? It say, in Solomon's temple, a large molten sea of bronze was placed on the backs of the 12 bronze oxes or bulls. These oxen being symbolized as the 12 tribes of Israel, this bronze sea was used for performing baptism for the living. See that? There were no baptisms for the dead until after the resurrection of Christ. See that? Listen to this. There were no baptisms for the dead. This is talking about an alchemical process. Until after the resurrection of Christ, see the crucifixion of the physical body. Then you go through that alchemical process of those four elements. You know what I'm saying? Those four baptisms. The four stages of baptism. Fire, where the earth was the physical body. The fire of the physical body. The water, the body is 80% water of the physical body. In the air of the physical body, or the oil of the physical body. You know what I'm saying? Those four stages. It's the oil baptism, the fire baptism, the water baptism, and the earth baptism. Those are the four stages. You know what I'm saying? The fire, the air, the water, and the oil. You know what I'm saying? Those are the stages of that baptism that you must go through. You know what I'm saying? So that's another understanding of baptism and the 12 bulls of heaven. They are the 12 daughters of Isis. The woman aspect has always been with us, and she gonna always be with us. You know what I'm saying? In the physical world or the celestial realm, celestial realms. As above, so below. As below, so above. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on. All right. Now we're gonna talk about Naga, who stole Sophia's life. You know what I'm saying? So let's get with that. Let's talk about Naga, who stole Sophia's life. You know what I'm saying? This is the rest of what the video was about yesterday, about the light that Naga stole. Naga really is self-will. self-will manifests itself in this physical realm as Yaldabaoth. But self-will was first. That was the first creation that Sophia created, self-will. And then self-will manifests as Naga, or Yaldabaoth, the lion-faced dragon. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. Go to the right-hand side. It says, at this time, free will or self-will prevented other gods. See that? That you know it's not free will, it's self-will. Prevented other gods from enthroning another creator. See that? Because they took over Amun. Amun look in the middle right there. Look in the middle. Look in the middle of those pictures. See the picture of the Anunnaki right there in the middle. You see how the colors are red, yellow, and black. See the Anunnaki in black, then you got the yellow sun, and then you got the red all around it. Red, yellow, and black. You know what I'm saying? Red, white, and black. See the red in the picture in the middle? Then you got the red, you got the white, and then you got the black. You know what I'm saying? Those are the colors. It's really four colors, but they're just showing you I'm gonna stay with what the words say on the writing, so you can stay with what's going on. But Naga took over things from the celestial realm. Let's go back to the read. From the celestial realm, bear with me. Back to the read. Okay, let's read again. It say, at this time, free will prevented other gods from enthroning another creator or destroying what other creators had created. So what he did was, the first star that he stole the light from, Naga or Sokwil, it was Saturn. And he said, anybody else gonna make another creator god, another Amun, which is Saturn. Saturn is Amun. If you look at the picture, you see Saturn at the bottom and you see Amun at the top. That's the one in the Anunnaki thanked all the time. You know what I'm saying? So self-will stopped them in this lower realm, in an alchemical process on a lower level. You know what I'm saying? At this time, self-will prevented other gods from enthroning another creator, to my Amun, the divine mother, or destroying what other creators had created. So he destroyed what was created or turned it upside down, because he was going to use it to create his world. That's why he stopped from destroying it. The truth of the Eye of Durga. Durga is Barbula. Watched over all the living, all that lived in the light of the galaxy. That's Durga. That's Barbula. But just as Naga envied Sophia, see that? He envied Sophia, his mother. He also grew tired of the young sun god. That's talking about Amun. Becoming ever more irritated by Amun's people. That's Sophia's people. You know what I'm saying? Amun's people or Isis people. You know what I'm saying? The star seeds or the children of light or the SUNs. We went through an alchemical process. That's why I said we was white like the stars of heaven in space. That's why I said that. You say, more irritated by Amun's people. That's why the Bible said you're going to shine like the stars of heaven. That's why I said white is an asteroid when it's in space. It's white. In the celestial realms, it's white. It say, becoming ever more irritated at Amun's people, we are the stars of heaven. That's what the Bible said you're going to shine like the stars of heaven again. You're going to go back to that alchemical process, that baptism. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say that when the before meter falls to the earth is white. More irritated by Abu's people in the celestial realm or Sophia's golden age of the new golden earth. See that? The children of the golden age. That's why they had golden bulls. And that's why they made golden calves. Remembering the age of Sophia. The celestial children. Amen got tired of them. In the Garden of Eden or Atlantis. In the Americas. You know what I'm saying? That's why he got tired of them. He got tired of the Garden of Eden in the Americas. The golden age. You know what I'm saying? He got tired of that. He wanted to create himself. He was jealous of Sophia, of his mother. You know what I'm saying? Amun's people of the new golden age, see that? The Garden of Eden. You know what I'm saying? That's why I said we got kicked out of the Garden of Eden by Yahweh. You know what I'm saying? He decided it was time to reclaim his creation. See, he think he created us. And he did on the physical realm, but he was a blind God. He thought he did it all, but he didn't. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to the right-hand side. It says, Naga decided to return to the source of all stars himself and steal fire. See that? He did steal Sophia's fire, but it was it was Durga. That was the light of Sophia. So he stole Sophia's fire over Sophia's earth. So he didn't actually take it from Sophia herself when he was born. It was actually because Sophia was more than just Sophia itself. Sophia was the aspect of all creation. You know what I'm saying? In many different forms. Sophia, Barbilo, and Pistis. All three of them. You know what I'm saying? So it was a combination depending on what aspect they create themselves in. You know what I'm saying? Naga decided to return to the source of all stars himself and steal fire. That's what he stole from Durga or Barbila. He went to her and stole one of her eyes. You know what I'm saying? I mean, not Durga. Well, Durga, but he stole one of one of Durga eyes and he brought it back. And that's how he was able to conquer Amun and Langa. Langa is our sun in the sky today. That's not shining the way it's supposed to shine neither. He blocked some of that light too. But he also cut Saturn all the way out. That gave life. That connected us back to the universe itself. You know what I'm saying? Bear with me for a second. That connected us back to the universe itself. Bear with me. That light right there, it connected us back to the universe itself. Amun, the great mother star. You know what I'm saying? It says, Naga decided to return to the source of all stars himself and steal fire from the eye of the mighty goddess Durga. The mighty goddess Durga is Barbila. Only with her fire could he reclaim his earth. See that? Only with her fire could he reclaim his earth and banish Amun. See that? Amun was Sophia's son, that light. So he stole her light. You know what I'm saying? Sophia's light. In that respect, he stole her light. But he also stole the stone from Barbilo's eye. You know what I'm saying? It said, only with her fire could he reclaim his earth and banish Amun, which is Saturn, from his place. They say his, but it's her. Because Amun, I showed you before, Amun is feminine. From her place in the solar tree, Naga traveled great distances beyond the speed of light, moving through time and space until he reached the center fire of Durga. Durga is our Barbilo, using his magic to deceive the goddess by becoming invisible to her sight. He turned one eye. Into a terrible stone. See that? The eye, the six and the nine, which is one of Barbilo's eye. He stole a stone out of her eye. Let's read on. Now this ain't on the screen. That will become the focus of his distorted desires. Naga had created a key into another world. See that? He made another world. That's the physical world, the world of time. From this world, a terrible God appeared. See that? Self-will created Yaldabaoth. You know what I'm saying? It's saying that would become the focus of his distortion desires. Naga had created a key into another world. See, the physical world. From this world, a terrible God appeared. See that? He made the physical realm where Yaldabaoth was born. Watch this. A terrible God appeared. A combination of Naga, which is self-will, and Durga, which is Barbila. Listen to this. Naga and Durga. Part lion, part serpent. See that? Yaldabaoth. Part lion, part serpent. See that? Yaldabaoth. Self-will is Naga. But some people say self-will is Yaldabaoth. It depends on what you read. You know what I'm saying? It depends on what you read. You know what I'm saying? So self-will birthed Yaldabaoth. Part lion, part serpent. That's Yaldabaoth from self-will. That's why when Sophia was fighting Yaldabaoth and whooping Yaldabaoth behind, self-will came down to help Yaldabaoth. Remember that? Remember that in the Naga body? You know what I'm saying? It's a Naga and Durga. It's a combination. It's a from the world a terrible God appeared. A combination of Naga, which is self-will, and Durga, which is Barbila. Part lion, part serpent. Peering through the key, Naga acts of deception created a schism called a demiurge. See that? Called a demiurge. See that? Called a demiurge, which is Yaldabaoth. Self-will created him. A self-aware distortion of the true light of Durga, which is Barbila. As the face of the demiurge form, Naga, which is self-will, then retch into the fire and looked fire and took a stone. See that? He took one of Barbilo's eyes, the stone, from the eye of Durga, which is Barbila. One of the many stones that were used to create planets and suns. And it, so it was, Naga now held the fire in his hand while he made haste back to Shekinah and the earth he had created. Naga would become the light bearer mentioned by those that would later survive what he set in motion. And as he entered the realm of Amun, he cast a shadow of darkness over the golden earth. Now let me go to the picture of that. Let me read that again. See Naga, see self-will taking the eye of Durga, which is Barbilo, and he used that creative stone to take over Amun, which is Saturn. See, Durga is the eye on the left-hand side. Amun, which is Saturn, is when Yaldabaoth, self-will took over Saturn, or Amun, and made it Saturn. You know what I'm saying? See how he's sitting inside of Saturn right now? And he took it over? Listen to this right here. It say, Naga now held a fire stone in his hand while he made haste back to Shekinah, meaning our galaxy, and the earth he had created. It say Naga would become the light bearer mentioned by those that would survive what he set in motion, talking about the physical world and time. And as he entered the realm of Amun is Saturn. See the picture on the right? That's Amun, or the Anunnaki's god, before he took it over. Realm of Amun, that's the goddess. Amun Ra. He cast a shadow of darkness over the golden earth. See that? using the fire that he had held like a torch. Naga's flame appeared as a new sun in the sky, moving near to Sophia. And so began the time of the fallen sun. See that? Well, watch this. The fallen sun and the sun that moved. See that? See, the suns we had didn't move. When it said the sun that moved, it's talking about time. Because when it started moving, it was ticking. When the sun started, when he took over Langa, which is our sun in the sky right now, that make it move, that's when time started. It made time start ticking. When he made Langa, the sun that's in the sky right now, he took away some of his light too, which is Ra, and he made it start moving, which was a clock of the 6,000 years. See, he didn't know what he did. He didn't know Barbilo made him create time to tick-tock his time away. So he took over Amun, which is the great mother, Isis, you know what I'm saying, and made her Saturn. That's why the other gods worship Saturn, because that's self-will inside the heart of Saturn, and they worship him. That's their god, self-will. Self-will made Yaldabaoth, who is the demigod. Self-will is inside of Saturn right now. But Amun is breaking loose. You know what I'm saying? That's why the green light coming on the earth right now. Because Amun is breaking loose. The 6,000 years is over. You know what I'm saying? So he kicking self-will ass up out of there. You know what I'm saying? So that's what's going on right now. You know what I'm saying? So that's why the whole earth is changing. These are absolute truths. Amun, which is Saturn, was only supposed to be took over for 6,000 years. Now the 6,000 years is almost up. She restoring herself. She kicking his ass out. Get out of here, self-will. You know what I'm saying? She restoring and coming back to who she really is. Amun. Everything is an alchemical process. Everything is an alchemical process. Either it's going to be an alchemical process going down or alchemical process going back up. That's why Thoth say I am, which is wisdom, I am the alchemical magician. I am an alchemical magician. You went through alchemical process like I show you with the cows. It say when you are a cow, you're a white cow. That means you Christ. And you come down to the physical realm as a star. You white. Then when you coming down to earth, you red. That's the red cow. You know what I'm saying? And you going through an alchemical process. And then when you hit the earth, you turn black, which is carbon. You know what I'm saying? And you the black cow. You know what I'm saying? That's an alchemical process. As above, so below. As below, so above. So while you on earth, you black. But the divine soul, which is the temple of God in that blackness, the light into the darkness, and the darkness coming into the night, which is the blackness, which is Christ, the feminine aspect, got to go back up to the white light or the green light. You know what I'm saying? The light you can't see. You know what I'm saying? So that's the process of the chemical process. Those are the 12 daughters of Isis and the 12 signs of the zodiac, which are the animals. You know what I'm saying? Which represents the 12 tribes of Israel. The 12 daughters of Isis have always been with us. And they're going to always be with us. That's why they tell you to despise the zodiac, because that is part of your strength and that's your power. Those are the influences over you. You know what I'm saying? And it represents your people. You know what I'm saying? So that's another understanding of what the baptism means. It's an alchemical process. When you are crucified, you are resurrected. Resurrection is a high vibration. You know what I'm saying? Up to 144,000 hertz. You know what I'm saying? So that's what that is. You're up to 144,000 hertz and greater. That's what crucifixion really means. Resurrection, which is a higher vibration, 144,000 hertz or even greater. You know what I'm saying? That's what crucifixion really means. Resurrection, reborn. 144. In the zeros, it's feminine. You know what I'm saying? Zeros is feminine. So that's feminine hertz in the masculine process. You know what I'm saying? But it's balance and harmony of both aspects, the physical realm and the spiritual realm. It's balance, it's authority, it's harmony. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, I give thanks to the angel of Ether. With that being said, I give thanks to the angel of earth. You know what I'm saying? With that being said, I give thanks. Bear with me. What's going on here? Bear with me. Okay, let me do that again. So with that being said, I give thanks to the angel of ether. I give thanks to the angel of earth. I give thanks to the angel of fire. I give thanks to the angel of water. And I give thanks to the angel of air. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for coming out. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you want to leave a comment, leave a comment. You know what I'm saying? But thank the great mother. You know what I'm saying? Because everything we do is recorded. So leave a comment. Let the great mother know what you feel, what you're saying, and that you agree with what she is doing. So with that being said, brothers and sisters, peace be unto you. Shalom.